Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Ritu Sharma. I'm a faculty at National Law University, Delhi. As we are here under the MOOCs program explaining about various modules under research methodology, I'll be discussing a module on case study. Hope other modules have been very helpful to you. So keeping in view with the other modules, I'll be discussing with a beautiful method called case study method, which is a very important method and which will give you an in-depth understanding about the research methodology. In understanding the case study method, we have laid down some learning objectives. They are: one, to understand the meaning and definition of case study method, to understand the argument for and against the case study method. We'll also be talking about the characteristics and types of case study method. Then we will be designing and analyzing a case study, and after that, in end, we'll be studying about the advantages and the disadvantages of case study method. And as you know, there are so many methods in research methodology, and when we think about empirical research, we often think in terms of questionnaire, interview schedule, survey, etc. But there is a method which is completely different from these techniques. The method is called as case study method. A case study method involves the systematic understanding of the information about a person, event, group, nation, etc. In other words, it is an in-depth study of a person, event, group, nation, etc., and it helps in narrowing down the research from a broad topic to a narrower topic. It is not just a data collection technique, but a methodology in itself. A case study uses a number of data collection techniques like oral history, documents, participant observation, and in-depth interview. Case study can be focused on an individual or a group, on a community or a society. A single case doesn't have to mean just one single person. It might be a family, a social group, or even a single organization. A case study can involve dealing with quite a number of individuals actually. For example, a case study may involve interviewing staff in a small but growing computer company on the social psychological aspect of managing staff. This information could then be used to compare with other or larger companies in terms of how they had tackled staff management issues at a similar stage in their history. It is important to determine the area of social life or event that needs to be studied. For example, if we want to study about a family, just interviewing the family members might not be sufficient, as family members might not give the required data. The researcher then need to talk to the members of the neighborhood to get the required data. In case studies, this becomes important, as the interaction with the other members of the community will also become relevant data for the researcher. Here, each case is treated as a single case. Researcher like Robert K. Yin defines the case study research method as an empirical inquiry that investigates a contemporary phenomenon within its real-life context. When the boundaries between phenomenon and context are not clearly evident, and in which multiple sources of evidence are used, researchers have used the case study research method for many years across a variety of disciplines. Social scientists in particular have made wide use of this qualitative research method to examine contemporary real-life situations and provide the basis for the application of the ideas and extent of methods. Case study is often confused with ethnographic account. Nilika Mehrotra, in the course that she developed on the field research for IGNU, differentiated between the two. She says, what distinguishes case study from more general ethnographic report is the details, and particularly of the account. Each case study is description of specific configuration events in which a particular set of actors have been involved in some defined situation at a particular point of time. In setting out a case study, the analyst must decide in advance at what point to enter the ongoing flow of event and at what point to withdraw from it. It should emphasize on the theoretical connection between the events rather than the events themselves. Any technique can be used for the collection of data, and it is preferably to operate with social fields, since data beyond what is strictly germane to this purpose are redundant. Thus, a case study method is a very important method, and it has been used by physicians and psychologists for many years to examine their cases. This method is also used in business and law curricula to help students to bridge gap between foundation studies and practice. There has been a debate on case study method, whether it should be used or not. So there have been various arguments regarding the use of case study as a method or technique of data collection. Some thinkers argue against the use of case study as a method. According to them, a case study method gives a narrow account of the individual family situation or event. The other set of thinkers are in favor of using case study as a method or technique, as it gives a holistic understanding of the individual family situation or event. To avoid such an argument, a researcher can use case study as a method, adding general statistical process to it. This way, he or she can synergize the two perspectives and conduct a holistic research of the issue. For example, a statistical survey might give the information on the quantity of the data, like how much time children spend watching television or internet, but in the it is the case study method of the group that will determine why they do so. Another important thing about the case study is that it might introduce new and unexpected results during its course and just not prove or disapprove hypothesis. This aspect is important as it leads the researcher to a new direction and paves way for many new researches. Moreover, case study might not be that much useful in physical sciences, but for social sciences, it is very important method of data collection. The case study method makes research more interesting than a purely statistical research.